Hello, Cancers. I hope you guys are doing wonderful. This is going to be your February 2019 Tarotscope. I had to think about that for a moment. It's been a long freaking day. I'm trying to get it out. I made a bunch of excuses in the Taurus video. The dog ate my homework, the moon. I made all kind of excuses. And they were all excuses. So, I'm going to be on point with this. Cancers, what's going on for you for February 2019? Any messages, Spirit? Any guidance? Any messages? Any guidance for my Cancers? One more time, Spirit. Thank you. They know I have to have my cards fall a certain way. Or I can't do it. All right. So, we got, is that King of Air? Seven of Pentacles, Page of Cups, Five of Wands though, the Wheel, the Emperor, Eight of Cups, Renewal, Nine of Wands, the Lovers, Chariot, ooh, the Ego card, King of Fire, Three of Fire, Four of Cups, Five of Pentacles, Knight of Air, Ten of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles. Money coming in for the Cancers. Yeah, for the Cancers. All right, so let's get it going. With King of Air, some of you may be dealing with somebody. It could be an air sign, Libra, Gemini, or Aquarius that you could be having some words with. Could be that somebody is being very vocal or direct towards you and could be making you worry. It could also be a temporary pause or like a little break with somebody. So if you're dealing with a Libra, Gemini, or Aquarius, you could have a pause in a situation. And it could be because either a new person entered your life or a new person entered their life. And if the new person entered their life, vice versa, there could be conflict with this coming in with Page of Cups. Some of you, and I'm going to read it two ways because I feel like some of you definitely could be dealing with either water sign or fire sign person, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius. And I tried to say Aries before, so some of you could be dealing with an Aries where there was maybe some miscommunication or some butting of the heads because of something that was said, or either somebody thought somebody was seeing somebody. I feel like there's some confusion that's going on. So it could be you were in a relationship. Your partner is like, okay, who are you seeing? You're talking to somebody else. There's some conflict that's coming in. But I feel like for some of it, it's really miscommunication. Somebody's seeing it, but they're not seeing it in a way that it really is. I don't see cheating, but I feel for some of y'all could be on the verge. Or, you know, taking conversation with somebody else, kind of checking in with somebody else, but maybe not having sex with this person yet. And there could be some conflicts with this. For some of you, I feel like there is a relationship that's trying to start, but some of you are still maybe hung up on another person. And there could be conflict with the new person because of that. So either way, there could be a lack of communication or a break in a relationship because somebody's trying to figure some things out. Like, what am I trying to do? Do I really want to be in this relationship? Do I not want to be in this relationship? With the Emperor card next to the Five of Wands, I feel like some of y'all could be having an affair with somebody who's married. This could also be your husband too. But I feel for some of y'all that there could be a temporary pause in a communication with somebody because they're married. They're either trying to work on their relationship with their person or they're pulling away from you because some conflict started And they were like, okay, you know, we got to cut this short. I got to pull away. You know, my wife and my husband is looking through my phone. They're looking through things because I feel like conflict is coming because somebody is stepping out. Doesn't apply to everybody, but for some of you, it will. Some of you are dealing with a person who's married. And there's conflict with it. The married person, I feel like, thinks the other person is cheating. Like, you're cheating on me. I know you're seeing other people. I know you're talking to other people. How can you cheat on somebody who's married, right? They already got a partner. So you just free willy-nilly. But for some of you, you could have a dominant married person who feels like they own you. Like you're only supposed to have sex with them. And if you're flirting with other people or whatever, they could have problems. Now, if this is happening for a lot of you, this is going to be temporary. If you're having an affair, dealing with somebody who's cheating on their partner to be with you, and there's a lack of communication or a conflict, it is showing that this is temporary, that it's going to start back up. At some point, this person is going to start talking to you again, or you're going to start talking to this person again, because y'all really not ready to let this go. It won't apply to everybody, but for some of you, it will. Now, for some of you, you could be feeling depressed because you were dealing with somebody and you have a relationship with a person, you're married or something like that, and this other person is giving you grief. You know, there's an issue with them. It's like, what the fuck? What do you, you know, what do you want? You knew I was married or you knew I was in a relationship. Either way it goes, if you stop talking to them or they stop talking to you, it looks like there's going to be some communication that comes back in. Now, for some of you, if you are married with the Eight of Cups, some of you want something deeper. This could even be a desire to move on to something else. Now, if this is not for a relationship, this could even be for business, dealing with somebody who's in a position where they feel like, I want more. I want to move forward to something more challenging, a different type of job. The Wheel of Fortune is saying that some of you could be putting your resumes out there looking for it, trying to move yourself in a more positive direction. Could be wanting to leave a job. For some of you, this could even be conflict with a boss. And for some of you, this could be conflict with a boss that you're actually sleeping with. So, Cancers, y'all get complicated. Y'all get complicated this month. For some of you, your emotions are involved in something. They cutting it off from me. Why are they cutting it off? What, I thought it was good. I thought it was great. I thought we was moving forward. Now, not all Cancers. Some of y'all are son of a guns. Y'all just like, you know what? I'm going to sleep really good on my pillow because I know they're calling me back. But some of y'all are having little meltdowns, stressing, worried, little conflict back and forth. Why are you doing this to me? Why are we doing this? So for some of you, definitely relationship issues. If it is a job situation, some of you just want to move towards something that is a little bit more challenging. The Renewal card is about moving in a new direction. For some of you, this is walking away from a relationship that maybe is not giving you everything you need because you feel like you got to stand your ground. Somebody could be calling your bluff. You know, some of you are feeling like, okay, you really don't think I'm going to leave. You think you're going to stop talking to me and I'm going to keep holding on to you. Well, I'm fixing to move in a different direction. Peace. I'm out. For some of you, this could be a job. I want to do something more. I don't feel challenged here. I don't feel like I'm doing anything. This is also spiritual growth too for some of you. And it could be the catalyst on why some of you feel like you need to walk away from a situation that is not feeding you anymore. For some of you, you're walking away because you met somebody new. This could be a King of Cups, Leo, Aries, Sagittarius person. This person could be free and clear because for some of y'all with Three of Wands, this is making long-term plans, putting energy into somebody, wanting something more meaningful, something deeper, something that can grow. And for some of you, the Renewal card, I'm moving forward towards something that gives me stability, gives me a family. So if you are having an affair with somebody who's married, for some of y'all, y'all are cutting it off. You're standing your ground. I don't want to do this anymore. Look at her face. She's serious. I don't want to do nothing. I don't want to do this with you no more, mofo. I can't do this with you no more. I'm moving on. I want my cups full. All my cups are not full. I want the Ten of Cups. And you're not offering me that. You're offering me a little. And then somebody else could be coming in and wanting to offer me more stability. So for some of you, you could get that. With the Four of Cups, this is about being discontent and bored. Wanting to move towards the Ace of Cups, Eight of Cups, but could be Ace of Cups too. Wanting to move towards love. So for some of you, you could be bored and feeling like, I need to move towards something. I'm not happy. I need this energy, this fire energy in my life. Somebody that motivates me. If this is not a person, it's an energy. I need to focus on long-term plans, abundance, doing some things that make me happy. So whether this is a platonic friendship, a romantic friendship, romantic love, or a job, or with a coworker, some of you are like, I'm not feeling valued. I'm not feeling like I'm getting something that I need. And I want to move towards that. So I'm going to focus on me. Now, some of you really want this reconnection with this person because you're laying really on your pillow. Are they going to call me? Diva, what? Y'all going to be calling me next week with these love readings? Are they coming back? Are they coming back? For some of them, yeah, but they're still married to their person. If you're the one that's married, somebody's not walking away from a situation. There's some unhappiness there. Somebody's bored, discontent. Something is going on. It's a cycle that's going over and over, and there's no growth. That's why somebody wants the growth. They want the Three of Wands. They want abundance. They want to make long-term plans. If this is a job, you hit the wall with this. You don't want to do this anymore. I want to be challenged. The Lover's card is about decisions. Needing to make a decision. What way do I want to go? This could be between two people, a person who's married and somebody who's single. Do I keep dealing with the person who's attached? Now, if they're not married, they could have a boyfriend, girlfriend, be living with somebody. Nowadays, you know, marriage, really, even the way I read it in cards, doesn't necessarily mean legally. So for some of y'all, you could be torn between air sign and a fire sign. Could be a decision that needs to be made. Some of you, I feel like with the Chariot card and with the Three of Wands, maybe trying to take the focus off of a romantic or this friendship thing. I don't maybe want to deal with this right now. And I think with the Chariot card, you want to move forward because some of you are having money problems or fears about money. It's like I'm distracted with the Knight of Air, Knight of Swords. I feel distracted. I think the thing about it is that with the Knight of Swords, this is about really figuring out what you want. There's something that's coming in that could be challenging you. There could be a person that's challenging you. And it's like, do I really want this? Is this something that's good for me? And for some of you, you're having a hard time making decisions because maybe you need to focus in more on work because you got bills that are coming in. This other stuff that's going on, for some of you, the relationship may not be your priority. And this lack of communication may be showing you that maybe I need to look at something different. For some of you, the job that you're in is just not paying you enough. It's not fulfilling you. It's not giving you what you need. You have material things that you need. You want nice clothes. You want to drive a nice car. You want to be able to eat vegan. You know, that shit costs money. Vegetables and fruit ain't cheap. You know? So for some of you, it's like, I need to focus on this. And I think for some of you, you don't have a choice. You have a relationship that may not be going well. And it's like, well, I can't really dwell on that. They're not texting me. They're not calling me. Or our communication is off. So I'm going to stop calling them and texting them for right now. Get my shit together. Six of Pentacles is showing that you got money coming in. This could be income tax. This could be within a new job. Some of you may be even starting a new career that brings in a Ten of Pentacles, which is what you want. Your bills are paid. You're walking away from this Five of Pentacles where you don't have enough money to Ten of Pentacles where you have more than enough. You can pay Xfinity, T-Mobile, you know, your water bill, your light bill, your rent, your car payment on time. You ain't got to wait a week after and get that late charge. You are moving towards something that gives you more stability. And for some of you, you need it because you're afraid. With the Ego card and with the Five of Pentacles, you know, they might come repossess my shit. I cannot lose my shit behind not having any money. So for some of you, you're waiting for money to come in. You're either waiting for a news about a job, a loan, income tax, some type of bonus settlement to come in because you're like, I need this money. It's already spent for some of you. Some of you, it's already spent. For a few of you, you're going to use it to get a car. It's going to be a nice car too, because with the Eagle card, y'all want to drive something nice. That's your preference. I want to look nice. I want to be in a nice car. So for some of you, you need this Ten of Pentacles to pop in, because you got shit you got to do. The long-term plans, when you turn around and if you use this King of Fire as an energy next to this Three of Fire, your hard work pays off and brings you to this Ten of Pentacles. I almost said Ten of Cups, so I think some of you want the stability of a Ten of Cup. Relationship, you want a family, something that's solid. Some of you may be dealing with somebody, whether they're married or not, who's not offering you anything solid. You're bored. You're discontent. You want more. I don't think Cancers, for y'all, it's about money. Y'all want the money. Cancers like money. You know, most of the time they have more money than what they actually say they have. But I do feel like for some of y'all, y'all want stability. You're tired of dealing with people, whether this is a friendship or a love, that they leave you hanging. They leave you hanging. They're, you know, there's unnecessary worry. Why am I sitting up here in the bed worried about this person calling me? Why am I really worried about this? For some of y'all, you know, there's decisions that need to be made. If there is marriages that are going on, some of y'all have to make the decision. Do I want to stay in this marriage, or do I want to walk away from this marriage and be with another person? Or is this person going to walk away from their situation and be with me? Spirit is saying it's unnecessary worry for some of you, because this person is going to call and come back and the cycle starts over again. And you're going to replay this cycle until eventually you get tired of it, or the person gets tired of it, or their spouse or partner finds out and puts an end to it. But for some of y'all, you really are having money issues. So it's almost, I keep getting this feeling like somebody's saying, I got to get my shit together. I really got to get my shit together. Some of y'all, I don't feel like you necessarily want to be married to a person. You might just want to be in a committed relationship, but you want the stability. You don't want to have to worry about money. You don't want that energy. So I do feel for some of you, that is the thing where you're moving, you're trying to push yourself towards happiness and more stability. Even though the Ten of Cups isn't showing that's what you want. You got a lot of money cards that are showing you have money coming to you. Seven of Pentacles is unnecessary worry if you're worried about money, because it's showing with Ten of Pentacles is going to be better than what you thought. But for some of you, you could be involved with somebody that you work with and that could be affecting your performance or your money. You know, you go to work and the person ain't called you and you're looking into their office or their cubicle. You know, you can't, end of the day, your shit's still on your desk. You can't, because you know, you're trying to make eye contact with somebody and they could be ignoring you. They could be, I feel like this is very immature energy. Even though it's showing as a King of Swords, I feel like you could be dealing with somebody that's very petty. They want things their way. They could even be a little bit of a control freak. I'm going to do this to make this other person jump through hoops. And for some of y'all, y'all are jumping through the hoops. Please, 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 Diva, when are they going to call? When? Can we do a money jar on them? Are we going to work a money lamp? To be honest, for some of y'all, this person, if they're married, they're not walking away from their relationship. If they're in a long-term relationship, they're stringing you along, because there's conflict that comes with this. There's conflicts that come with it. Somebody's having a hard time explaining to you why they can't be with you, or you telling them why you can't be with them, or the wife is talking to them, I know what you're doing, the husband is saying, all right, I found this out, or whatever. There's a lot of conflict going on. Won't apply to everybody, but for some of you, it definitely will connect. For some of you, you have met a new love, but you still may be thinking about somebody from the past that you were involved with, and you're having a hard time maybe walking away from this. For some of you, you are involved with a boss. And there's decisions that need to be made. I do feel for some of you, if you are working in a situation where it's like, I can't work with this person because I got feelings for them, some of y'all are going to move forward. I feel like if you are dealing with a boss, and this won't apply to everybody, this could be to someone specific, I feel like this person is purposely holding you back. They don't want you to be promoted. They don't want you to do better, because they're trying to keep you in their area or keep you underneath them, which is really bad. But I feel like there's an ego situation with somebody. You have the potential to grow and to do really good things, but you have somebody that you work under, whether this is a friendship or a romantic relationship, that is, they're keeping you from growing. But with the Ten of Pentacles, some of y'all are going to get from under that energy. Nine of Wands, standing up for myself, putting my foot down. Look how she got a spear. You thought she was holding me back. Let me show you. I'm making long-term plans. I got shit to do. Opening your eyes to possibilities. Thinking that things are not turning out for you, but opening your eyes because you want more. You want stability. And if it's money that brings it, you're going to work yourself for it. Definitely moving towards the Ten of Cups because you want it. So for some of you, you know, I do feel like there's some type of decision that needs to be made, whether this is to work in a job, leave a job, stay in a relationship, leave the relationship. Some of you won't have a choice because the person picks their spouse or their partner and they stop talking to you. They just ghost you. And I feel for some of you, this is going to hurt you, because for some of you, this is like a long-term thing. This has been over a year of dating, you know, maybe started off as like a fling or something like that. But it really hurts you when this person stops talking to you. And for some of you, that's the conflict. You're going to be texting, calling, because you want that closure, or you want the person back and they're not giving it to you. And some of you are dealing with somebody who's married that's just like, the game is over. I don't want to play anymore. There definitely is movement, but it's moving towards this. So that's a positive. You're not going backwards. For a lot of you, if you are dealing with all this energy, you're moving towards something that makes you stronger, because you're standing your ground and you're working your ass off to get to the Ten of Pentacles. And you are getting towards something that's more meaningful. So Cancers, for you, it's actually a good read. I mean, I feel bad if some of you are going through that energy, but you know, you're adults. Unfortunately, we know what we sign up for when we get involved with shit that we know is going to be a little bit messy or be a little bit chaotic, and you got to play it out. You got to learn the lesson until you're ready to move forward, and then you move forward. So Cancers, I love you. You know, Ten of Pentacles is a good thing. I'm happy that a lot of you are moving towards that, and a lot of financial burden is going to be coming off of your back. You deserve it. Love you guys.